Could write you a song to make you fall in love. I would already have you up under my arm. I used up all
ladies and
my
gentlemen,
tricks. I hope that you like this, but you probably
before the video starts, I need y'all to rate my haircut real quick. I spent about $40 on it. My mom didn't even notice. $40 down the drain, bro. But like, she says it's down the drain, but at the end of the day, I be looking so good, bro. Look at this shit. Don't this look tough, man? Oh wait, you guys can't see. Doesn't, I don't know, bro. No, it looks good, bro. It looks good, bro. I think it looks good. Like, if I was in the club, I'd walk up to me. Anyways, today we got, what is this? The Downfall of Chantel. It's another sauce video, bro. I've really been feeling the sauce, bro. Look, if you guys don't know who Chantel is, Chantel looks like Tiana Trump if she found God. Or, like, Tiana Trump if she didn't suck dick. But, I mean, that's probably, like, half correct only because she doesn't have a husband anymore. So, I'm really not too sure. Also, real quick before the video starts, look, you guys don't even like try and guess what happened, bro. Don't even like try and guess what happened, bro.
Shout out to YouTube.
All that shit. Don't even like really try and guess what happened. I'll show you. Dashboard right here. Appeal rejected. My appeal was rejected. Ladies and gentlemen, my channel was on a warning.
What did I do? But YouTube, what did I even do?
They just don't want to see me win. They just don't want to see me win, bro. Look, I can't even look at y'all, bro. That hurt my feelings too much. Whatever, bro. Let's get into this sauce. Carry me through another blessed 15 minutes, probably.
We're here for the what?
Divorce party.
Because she's looking for the
I'm right here.
My name is Chantel. I'm 32 years old,
gosh,
and
bro.
I'm from Atlanta, Georgia. After being married to Pedro, I know for a fact that I don't want.
Okay, hold on. Look. Did y'all notice that though? Listen, watch closely. Be attentive, ladies and gentlemen. Be attentive. Pretend this is seventh period science class. All right. There's a quiz at the end of the day. I'm the substitute teacher.
My name is Chantel.
Now watch her mannerisms, all right? I'll say that again. Watch her mannerisms.
I'm 32 years old, and I'm from Atlanta, Georgia.
Atlanta, Georgia. Now, I don't know if that means she's retarded or...
After being married to Pedro, I know for a fact that I don't want anybody who belittles me. I want a man who's super successful.
Guys, that was a joke, all right? Because I know someone's going to comment. Guys, it was a joke, all right? It was a joke. Oh, my gosh. You don't know how many comments I get about that word?
And like a horse.
So, yeah, it seems like Chantel's been on this TV production rampage from family Chantel to now the single life literally during the midst of her divorce with Señor Pedro. And it begs the question if and when
Chantel... Okay, wait, hold on. This is Pedro. Pedro and Chantel, if you're not caught up with the beef, Pedro is Chantel's ex-husband.
Ever found a time,
I think, allegedly,
to fully heal and grow from her recent separation.
I didn't have that.
But I digress. So here she is in the great land of Greece, home of the Olympians, philosophy, mathematics, astronomy, olive oil.
Really?
Yeah, I think that's it.
She.
But no, so Chantel's here.
Like, he's just so... It's just so... thick.
Here today with her three amigos in this gray land to do some degenerate things in the modern slums. Dare I say, the current dating pool.
You say you right.
Things that would probably set her back another 5 years if done correctly. That's why choosing who you spend your time with and having discernment for unhealthy friendships and who's in your inner circle is so muy importante. The influence is crazy, man.
Okay, so here's the ground rules. Everything we say, you do.
Do.
Period. Five guys' numbers tonight.
No, girls don't just go up to guys and be like, what's your number?
We doing it today. Well, you don't have to, like, be what you were.
Yeah, Chantel, so everything we say, you do.
Do.
Period.
So when we're all hammered tonight on Nectar of the Gods and Greek yogurt vodka, I want you to channel your inner Johan and start microdosing cow piss. Open your mouth.
What about mushrooms?
Oh my god!
And remember, like Uncle Ben used to always say,
you don't have to, like, be what you were.
So on that note, Chantel's here, ready to mingle and find her Greek man, hand chiseled and carved out of her own imagination, literally.
Sparta, Spartans, strong men, nice body, washboard abs.
Look, I'm not even from Greece. I'm not even from Greece, Chantel. I might have 25% of everything you just said there, but I'm not even from Greece. Ain't that crazy, Chantel?
To myself, I would like a Greek man.
I've seen pictures of Greece, and I hope my imagination comes true.
This is where the Greek gods are. So I'm hoping.
A god out here for you?
Because you were with a peasant. Goddess.
My boy Pedro is going to be out here catching random strays all season.
What I do?
For no reason.
Bang, bang, bang.
Like Chantel literally could have said anything.
So guys, I did Romanian deadlifts for the first time on a plane ever. But now I'm not exactly too sure why my back feels like a white mocha frappuccino grande.
Because you were with a peasant.
Now, maybe I wasn't acutely aware before, but it seems to me like Chantel got a little bit of that Darcy DNA in her, you know? And if you didn't know, Darcy DNA has its own mission statement. I don't date Americans. I want me a foreign man's. Something like
that. Look, I'm not caught up with her either. Look, I'm so out of the loop, bro. I'm so out of the loop, I gotta catch up with her too, bro. Damn.
That only difference is Chantel dated Pedro. Who is Dominican, so her palate seems to stretch more than just the European continent. But I digress. Now, Chantel hasn't outrightly stated all of this, but, you know, a couple lines here and there, and you can make the assumption.
If I want to date an American...
Sorry.
Man,
dude, I'm very sorry.
They take so long to marry. American
sorry.
Men take at least 4 years to get married.
I prefer
what are you talking about?
Somebody from another country versus an American man.
Americans... don't really treat me the way I want to be treated.
Now I'm not saying Sean.
Don't include us in that category. Don't include me. Who are that motherfuckers over there, man? That ain't even fair. Chantel, right? That's the name? Chantel. Quit playing with me. Why are you doing that?
Chantel's wrong, but also there's other variables that Chantel's overlooking.
Yo, clip that and send that to her. Come on.
With these statements. Like, for example, the fear of divorce courts and marriage laws haven't exactly been too favorable for men, especially the men she wants.
I want a man who's super successful.
Thus, a lot of these guys tend to slow their roll before putting a ring on it. Also, when it comes to dating abroad, in many situations, the other party has an incentive outside of just love to get married ASAP. Hence, Pedro.
I am afraid of telling Chantel because I want to bring my family to the United States.
Now, Chantel, don't
sign herself up for it. See, Chantel, I would never do that to you. Oh my gosh.
All of this and more, and then have her and her family continue to bash it against your head anytime you guys have disagreements.
A scam that almost parallels human trafficking.
What?
To get him over to the United States, take advantage of the American economy.
It seems like now, it could be a marriage scam.
And that's just a part of the scam. And you know what the truth is?
Whenever they say that to me, that's the first thing. I'm like, okay, so this guy's a scammer.
He wants to separate because he was here for a green card. We all said it.
We knew what he was here for.
From the start.
It wasn't about being here with Chantel. He's wanting to be here.
Pedro has proven me right. He was only with Chantel for what he could get.
Hence, Pedro's divorce. But I mean, if you just want a foreign dude because you want to...
pull up in a foreign whip.
Then hey, by all means, carry on.
We just arrived in Greece. I have finally accepted.
Then hey, by all means, carry on.
We just arrived in Greece. I have finally accepted that I am single and I'm ready to start living again. This is going.
Hold on, where were they at though? Just for future reference.
Finally accepted that I am single and.
Hold on, I didn't see where they were. Were they showing it?
We just arrived in Greece. I have finally...
Where, wait. No, I don't think it's on the screen right now. I don't know. For some reason, I thought you guys wanted me to pause here.
Accepted that I am single and I'm ready to start living again.
This is going to be a very fun trip.
The trash has been taken out. She looks like a Greek goddess. We're going to own all of that.
Activate.
Okay, come on.
Hi.
What the Sims?
Can't tell.
Adonis.
That's crazy. Look, I thought the Greek nameplay only happens in like mythology books. I didn't know people actually walk around rocking these names.
That bro, he looks like Sheen.
James, that's kind of hard. Imagine getting approached. Adonis, Leonidas, Achilles. Like if I'm competing with somebody named Achilles, I might just rip out my own Achilles. Like that's too much. How's that even fair? Even if you're like Big Ed, but your name is Demetrios, that's an automatic left swipe.
You know what? That's kind of valid. Wait, which way is left? Oh, okay.
But hey, you got a cool name. That's a dub.
That's a W. That's E1.
Anybody speak?
That's E1. That's a W.
Anyhow,
L vape.
Anyhow,
Nah, hold on. This look is crazy, bro. He looked like the actor that would have been Megamind if Megamind wasn't Megamind.
So anyhow,
he kind of looked like a monkey too, bro. I don't get
so, anyhow.
No, because he kind of looks like my brother. it's so weird. It's so weird.
A sailor on a camera. A sailor?
Yeah, you like that?
Yeah.
Look. She gave it to you, bro. Come on, Mikey. Come on. Just go. Go ahead.
That's so exciting. Oh my God. Do you mind if I get your number?
Activate.
Yeah, so this whole interaction was probably as moist as a pack of vacuum sealed saltine crackers. Like, Lord knows, Sailor was probably not what she wanted to hear, but I mean, at this point, the man could have said anything.
So yeah, I'm actually a bum. A bum? Oh my God, that's so exciting.
Yeah, no, it's actually very depressing. I come here every Tuesday because Vasilio's giving out free darts, you know?
Hell yeah, dude. Can I get your number?
It's crazy. Now, we're not going to even talk about why she has a whole squad of dancing flamingos in the back.
Activate.
Like, if I'm Adonis, the only active mingos in the back.
Wait, you guys said there was the location, right? Oh, in like a couple seconds?
Activate.
Where's...
Like, if I'm Adonis, the only activating I'm doing is deactivating my phone after this one.
Oopsie. Guy in the black shirt.
Cute.
Do you want to take a drink? Let's just take a drink. Let's just have a drink.
You want to have a drink with us?
Okay.
What do you like?
Whatever you
like. Whatever. Oh. Okay.
How old are you?
20.
20?
Oh, you have a bite?
Yeah.
Can we still take it out?
I'm 21. Wait, hold on. The location was there too, right?
Yeah, let's not act like I didn't come off very oddly human trafficky. Hey, you, yeah, the guy that looked like Sid's sister? Yeah, you in a black shirt, come here. You want a drink? Let's take a drink. Just have a drink, dude. Just one flipping drink, dude.
Okay.
Now, she goes off with the kid, literally. He was like 12 when you married Pedro, but I digress. Comes back and then just out of nowhere started having Vietnam flashbacks.
No! No! This is happening to me again!
What happened?
Just, I don't know. I love me some Pedro. I don't know. Pedro took me on the four-wheeler.
I'm not even gonna lie to you right now. Look, I did not even mean to pause right there, bro. Like, there's no way I would have known this was here, okay? That's just D1 pausing, bro. I could have went to college for that shit. Listen up. Well, now I forgot what I was gonna say because something caught me off. I'm not really sure what it was that caught me off guard. I'm just gonna go face cam only because I feel like YouTube's kind of been on my snack a little bit. So let me, I don't even know what I was gonna say anymore, bro. Like, I... All right, Wait, hold on. Let's be... Oh, like, there ain't no... All right, let's just go. Stop
no.
it.
I'm about to get mad.
Don't turn the energy.
Do not do that.
Girl, what is going on right now?
What are you crying about?
Yo.
She ain't mad at me. Your
friend group is crazy. Crazy.
What are you crying about, Sean? Don't turn the energy. You're killing
Does
the vibe.
Does he have an earring inside of a gauge?
What are you crying about, Sean? Don't turn.
How is that possible? What am I looking at? Okay, is this connect? No. What is this connected to? That's got to be part of the gauge, right? Because look, this is stretching out the ear. And this, yeah, that's connected right there. I was about to say, bro.
The energy. You're killing the vibes. It's not really giving. Greek goddess.
Stop. Like, I'm sure they're cool people, right? I just don't know if they got your best interests at heart. For example, letting you hop on this two-wheeler motorbike after we peer pressure the driver to take a couple shots. Yeah, see, I don't know about that. Call me crazy, but can't be me. Fast forward to the second day in Greece, they end up going to make olive oil, right? Surprise, surprise. And the tour guy ends up being some Russian mob who's saying something like, so the females come here, they feel comfortable with us, we take them in. And we go potty, 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 and hasta luego after that. something like that.
So a lot of former count of Greece.
Females
feel very.
something like that.
So a lot of former count of Greece. Especially.
Nah. What the fuck is this bitch's at, bro? For real. Nah. I ain't even fucking lying to you right now. Hold on, bro. It's 90 Day Fiance, right? Nah, I'm really gonna need that Instagram, bro. Quick intermission, real quick, bro. Obviously, she's gonna go for me, guys. Don't even second guess it, bro. Don't even second guess it, bro. This is her? Okay. Well, the competition's gonna be a little tough. Oh shit, might as well shoot the shot. Might as well do it. Not a day like the present. Am I right? Is that the saying? I don't know. Alright. Let's move the mic to the side. Hey, Chantel. I saw you on TLC. Wow. Ain't nobody looking like you. I promise you so fine. Holla back at me.
Comfortable with us, like we show them like the clubs, everything, the nightlife. We go for party.
Okay, so we need to go check. We're going out.
Yeah, see, if it wasn't for the cameras, ain't no way I'm letting Mr. Evil Knievel, pretty boy Sean Yu, henchman, take me and my girlies to go party, 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 and we all end up on a milk carton, like a family portrait. Screw that. Yeah, screw all that, because call me Magic Johnson, I'm passing. But they end up going right because Chantel.
Bring on the men.
She thirsty.
Let me introduce my friend Yanis. Yanis, professional football player.
Yanis.
Chantel,
nice to meet you.
The guys are looking good.
Go ahead, Chantel.
I imagine a Greek.
Oh shit! Okay, it's working now.
Strong.
Look, bro, this mic. I have my microphone set up right now. Is so messed up, bro. Dude, my old setup, like, it was just so much better. Just, like, the wire management, everything, bro. I keep unplugging the microphone here. There's nowhere for me to put it. Like, there's just nowhere for me to put it. So it's like, whatever. I guess it's gonna have to be like over here, but I like to look over here, bro. That's my issue. All right, enough about me. Let's focus back on you, Chantel.
Spartan, just the washboard abs.
I guess.
Look, I don't know how many times we gotta hear Chantel talk about Spartan, strong man, washboard abs, like. Chantel, not everybody's name Leonidas. That's like you going to China and being like, I'm looking for a Jackie Chan. And that's looking like you. And you. And you. Y'all look like Jackie Chan. That's how crazy you sound to me. Now, what's crazy is her trying to push herself to fall for every guy she's been in contact with so that she can fill up this void that she hasn't healed from. Because that's the first thing they talk about when they're one-on-one.
Have you ever been married?
No, never.
Good. Yeah. But that's long gone. Like, so far behind me.
I don't know if it's just a Greek thing or a him thing to be so understanding, but I see it as a positive.
No, Chantel.
Hey, man. Chantel, let me be honest with you. It's a cold, cold world out there, Chantel. We all just trying to fuck. I'm gonna be honest with you. Shit, let's just get, like, well, I don't know what else to tell you.
Well, that's actually not a Greek thing or a him thing. That's a universal guy thing. Every guy has a dialogue script verbatim that works for any and all convos. Because everybody got a sad story. 9 out of 10 times, she wouldn't be here unless she got her heart broken. So, you know, let her spill out all the beans.
It's sauce cooking!
Just let her talk so that you can pretend to be the opposite of what she's yapping about. Pedro's mean. You're not mean. You're nice. Pedro is stingy. You're generous. You know what I mean? And you're off the rack. Somewhat tailored response is always going to be 45 degrees this way. That's crazy. Wish I could have been there for you. I feel like the universe, if you believe the man above,
he stole my script.
Two together for a reason, right? Or if she believes in the zodiac stuff, right? You're a Sagittarius, right?
Yo, Tyree put me on game. Scorpio. I'm gonna need me a Latina Scorpio. Oh my god. I promise you, I would never curse ever again if I had a Latina Scorpio. Are you kidding? Are you kidding, bro? And you might just be sitting there like, what the fuck? Bro, talking about Scorpio. Tyree put me on game last video. Tyree said Scorpios are freaks in the sheets, and I looked it up, and the motherfucking internet confirmed it. So wait, am I a crazy rock lady right now?
Pisces, the way my rising moon is set up, mixes really well. A lot of happy endings, family, commitment, trips, vacations, kindness, generosity. I see all of that. You know? And results will vary depending on how good your delivery is, but also by your attractive level, right? Like, if you're like me, he a weirdo. Or if you're like Brad Pitt.
I don't know if it's just a Greek thing or a him thing to be so understanding.
Now, clearly Chantel fell for the okey-doke, you know? Like, I don't even know if this guy's even a football player. You saw the way they introduced him? Here's my friend Giannis. He's a professional football player. Wait, what? I am? Oh, yeah, I'm Giannis. And clearly we see him celebrating at the end, right?
Tonight was a good night.
Hey, we packing them in sardines. But yeah, that pretty much wraps up the first two episodes of this season. I think third episode comes
out
next
week.
That was the second?
No, that was
okay. Around for Giannis and drives like 4 hours to go see him, which is crazy. And I don't exactly think this is healthy, you know? Like, it's obvious she's not over Pedro.
All right, so we got a video of Chantel done. I don't know, bro. Maybe we gotta go. Let's just check it out for tomorrow, bro. Like, I'm really invested in this series right now, bro. This is the only thing I want to do, bro. I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. I think there's one other person. It's Tyree and then someone else. Rob the Knob. Okay, is that the Russian bitch? I don't know. All I know is there's a Russian bitch. Maybe this is her. Alright. Yo, guys, welcome. I'm ending the video. Yo, guys, thank you for supporting, bro. Really do appreciate it. Thank you. Bye.